different approach to what it was going to do with a very senior, very experienced trainer, Ken Peters, and dragged him to the bottom of the pool and held him in the bottom.
If she was standing here with me right now, would tell you that it was her, that was her mistake in allowing that to happen.
It started as play or frustration and clearly escalated to be, you know, very violent behavior that I think was anything but play.
The victim is Daniel P. Dukes from South Carolina. Dukes was found yesterday draped over the back of Tillicum, the largest orca held in captivity.
One of the employees, I don't know if it was a physical therapist or somebody, was coming in the morning, and there was Tillicum, you know, with a dead guy, a dead naked guy on his back, kind of parading him around the back pool. Medical examiner reports were more graphic than that. For example, Tillicum stripped him, bite marks all over his body.
She grabbed her foot. Tamari whips around and she grabs the gate. You see her just ripped from the gate. At this point, Tamari knows that she's in trouble. She's under the water. Splash and Orchid both have her. She's totally out of view. No other trainer knows that this is happening. People start to scream, you know, as the park guest that was filming it. You hear, you don't see her, but you hear Tamari surface. You hear her just scream out, "Somebody help me." And the way she screamed it, it was just such a blood-curdling, like she knew she was gonna die. Rocket let her go. Her arm, it was U-shaped. It was compound fractured. She's very lucky to be alive, that's for sure.
You.